Are you creating content like video and sharing it on social media platforms like Instagram, Facebook, or YouTube, and you want to add your own brand, maybe an intro clip or a bumper? Well, today I'm going to show you how to create a 4-second clip that you can use just for that. So stick around. What's happening, everybody? Claudio here, and welcome to my channel. I am Claudius, where I share tips on how you can share your story. As I mentioned at the start, I'm going to show you a really cool way to create a 4-second clip that you can use for intros, bumpers, that you can add to your videos, maybe brand them. I'm going to show you how to do that. I'm going to be using my phone. I'm going to use an app called Adobe Spark Post. Really easy to do. So let's go ahead and dive right in. I'm going to launch Adobe Spark Post here and load up an image, tap on that green plus sign. Let me find something that's in my Creative Cloud. You can pull an image pretty much from anywhere. You can use a clip from your camera roll. I'm going to be using some photos that I took here in my office a while back. So let me scroll down here and locate those just about there. And I'm going to go ahead and use this one here. This is going to serve as kind of my background for this clip here. And since I'm going to be using this for my Instagram story, I'm going to choose that template size there and maybe kind of adjust it there and then tap on done. And now what I'm going to do is I'm going to remove some of these items here, but for this first text, this is going to be kind of my intro pretend show that I have here. It's a box here with the word the. I'm going to actually make some adjustments here. Let's do the spacing. We're going to adjust the spacing, and actually for the shape, we're going to be using this here because I want it to fill the whole top right here. Right about there, size it up, change it a little bit smaller. I can adjust the colors if I want here. Let's go with that there, maybe try that. Or that. Let's do that one there. Let's add another text here at the top. I'm going to call this the show just for a lack of creativity right now. For shape, this one, I want no shape for this one. I just want the text. I'm going to fit it right about there. Maybe make it a little bit smaller, adjust it. I'm going to take the word the here and make it a little bit smaller as well. Let's go back to spacing. It might take a little bit of time to tweak this. Let's move this up here to the top. Let's move that right about there. Maybe let's adjust the word show. Now, the reason I'm leaving a space in between here is I'm going to add an icon, kind of like a logo here. Let's use, see if a camera shows up. Camera. So I have all these different cameras. I'm going to use that one right there. And I'm going to fit it in between the word the show. Now, because it's blue, let me change it so that it's visible. Let's go with maybe, let's try, I like this contrast, this orange. Let's move that right there, kind of fit it there, cool. Maybe make a few minor nudge it over there as far as where I'm placing it. I may just make it a tad bit smaller. There we go. So it fits perfectly up there at the top. Cool. Now I'm going to add another banner at the bottom, another text here. I'm going to put my name and then the same thing. I'm going to go to shape. I'm going to choose that shape that kind of adds a whole banner across the bottom there, kind of like a lower thirds. And just adjust the spacing there. Spacing, adjust, see, align. I think I'm pretty good where I want it to be. And then bring this down to the bottom. What I may do is just make it a little bigger. Align it kind of centered there. And then I think what I may do is change the color up some here. Instead of that white, I'm going to be using that same orange there just to kind of go with that theme here. So, all right, I've got my kind of intro banner made. I've got my picture there. Now, you can use any picture there that you want. This one, basically what I'm going to be doing is animating this whole clip here, create that 4-second clip that I can use for my intro. So here's what I'm going to do. Right there at the bottom where it says animation, I'm going to tap on that. And then here is choosing different ways that the animation will show. So here, if I click play, it says the show and then my name at the bottom. Now you can scroll through here, choose different ones. Let's see how that one works there. Let's try the fade. And then at the bottom, that one looks pretty cool. I think I'm gonna go with that one there. Now, I don't know if you paid attention to what I was doing here, is I added each thing kind of in sequence. So first I added the with a shape, and then I added show, or actually I should say, yeah, I added show without a shape, and then I added the camera, and then I added my name at the bottom. So I did that in sequence so that when I add the animation, when I hit play, it shows up like that. Now, the next thing that I'll do is come up here to that share button, and instead of a still image, I'm going to choose video animation. So let it go through and animate this. So it's creating a 4-second video clip. If you think about it, you count 4 seconds, 1, 2, you know, it's a good length of time. So choose save video. It's saved in my camera roll. Let's go ahead and let's take a look at the final one. How does it look like? Cool. So now what I'll do is take that and drop it into like whatever software I'm using to edit, Premiere Pro, Premiere Rush, or whatever video editing software, making sure that it's sized up for, in this case, I'm using the Instagram story size, so that when I drop in this clip, it's right there at the intro, and then I can add all the other video clips afterward. Really neat way to create an animated kind of clip for an intro, as I mentioned, or a bumper, or even an outro. And that's a wrap. I hope you've enjoyed this video. If you have any questions, learn something new, let me know by adding it in the comment section below. Don't forget, hit that like button, subscribe to the channel if you haven't done so, and then click on the little bell to be notified for future videos. Thank you again for watching this one. And as always, keep creating and be good to one another.